I think with like clothing, it is a way to express yourself. It is a way that you can kind of go out there and be strengthening yourself in a way by putting on these colors and maybe quite expressive prints. And I think that's what clothes can do. And that I think is quite sort of beautiful. When I was a child, I was extremely shy. And as far as I can think back, I was spending most of my time by a sewing machine, making clothes for my parents, making clothes for myself. But it started with me making these like peplum jackets for my mom, that kind of curved around the body and had this feminine kind of touch. They were quite expressive in a way. This is also a jacket that has followed me for like almost every collection that I have done since I started. So here is one of the peplum jackets that we work with, and it's kind of this iconic piece for us. This is like with this kind of, the sway that goes out, it's done in this organza fabric where we have worked with a jacquard with these kind of flowery colors on as well. And then we have another one which is a bit more of a casual version that is done in twill kind of denim-y fabric with stitches and in a lovely kind of sage green. It makes that kind of strength when it curves around the body to you. But I was also making a lot of clothes for myself, which was quite out there. It was very expressive, super colorful. Sometimes I think it actually didn't really suit me, but it was a way that I could kind of express myself because I was so shy. It was almost like an unconscious thing for me when I was a child that this was something that was really like close to me in a way, that I could kind of get a little bit out there by dressing in these crazy colors.
Alligevel lader huset alle gardiner være trukket for. Ingen adgang til sollys på nær gennem det øverste vindue.
I en lærkrukkes bund har den sidste uges regnvand samlet sig, og nogle af husets andre beboere flyver der ned for at drikke.
De bliver opstemt af nedstigningen, vingerne basker vibrerende.
I've always, when I started my brand, I wanted to get people to feel that they could express individuality and feel that they could instead of some people, like maybe they dress to hide themselves a bit and hide maybe insecurities, I wanted to do the opposite, like with actually giving empowerment. Good design can be many things, but it's also about having, like, for me it's also been about having a red thread in what you're doing, so not like listening to what is going on out there, like, but and then going in that direction, but really kind of stay true to what you are, and stick to what the brand is about, and listening to your gut feelings. And but I think good design can also, for me, I think it's, if I buy something, it's also about the values behind. Which I think is really important now, that you can actually relate to what you buy, like the people behind or the thoughts behind the brand, and this is something that I think is really important, that it has, that good design has to have some good values as well.
Thank you.
I think if I was to name one inspiration or driving power for my designs, it would be color. I like to explore color and its beauty and its how it resonates with us. And color is like universal, but it's also like very personal. For some people it might be like sharp with edges, but for me it's very subtle and tender and almost like a meditation in a way. This is also why I surround myself with color, both in my working life, but in also in my living and how I dress. So I think color and then this kind of artistic approach to our collections. Yeah, we create all prints and artworks from our studio. And I've always had, since I started studying at Central St. Martin's in London, which was all about creativity and being very individual, and they had very much this kind of way of teaching us that we have to have some kind of reference from what we're doing and storytelling. And that's what I always want to do with my collection. I want to tell a story with it. So all prints and artworks comes from some kind of inspiration, which I think is something people buy into when they buy our collections.
And this is one of our show pieces that we did for our recent show. Here we have draped on a mannequin this kind of shape and how it's like gathered in at the top. We left the seams raw because we thought it made like a nice contrast that it was this very kind of elegant fabric, and then you have the raw edges at the sleeve. It's like an A-line kind of shoulder, and it has also this beautiful volume. We made a collaboration with a poetry group for this this season, and they made a special kind of text for us where the topic was how much can we grow, and we put it into the label. So this is how it will come. When you see it in the shops, it will have this kind of little story to it. And I think you can kind of take it, you can look into this quote in many different ways. It can be your own personal kind of development or reflection, and how much you can actually grow as a person. But this is something we love to do, is to collaborate with other people as well and bring more stories into the clothing that we do.
Hende med hånd, hun leder efter en lighter, dernæst en cigaret, febrilsk, de røde tagsten, Molly.
Du er dekoreret, Molly, ligesom sengegæret, kaminen, kakkelbordet. Vi kan kun male dig i de farver, som er fremlagt allerede. Du bliver døv. Du har en yndig frisyr.
The process of when I start designing the collections is that we gather as a team, like the design team, and we start looking at what kind of theme should be for this collection? What kind of story do we want to tell? And what should the vibe be? I mean, the collections we design are, I mean, right now I'm designing a collection that comes out in 1 year. So you have to kind of put your head around, like, what is it that you want to wear in a year, you know? So we start like creating color cards, spending time on using color swatches, making the right combination of colors. Because I think it's really important when you come into a showroom, you see like a nice story of like very subtle colors, but also colors that pop out. And then we start creating sketches for prints and figure out like what techniques should we do. Should it be with watercolor, or is it more graphic, like done in Illustrator? And then we kind of build these print boards to see where, how is the story looking together. And then we start sketching on like what kind of garments will look nice with these prints or colors. Suddenly you have a collection hanging with everything coming together. And this is an example of one of our like more storytelling prints that we've done on a scarf. The collection was called Deconstructed Dancer, and this is our deconstructed dancer made with this kind of collage technique. You can see that there's both like this painted kind of technique mixed with foil that is scanned, and then we have made this kind of stitching into the print, but then it also comes out as these like loose threads that I think is quite special. And here, of course, we've worked a lot with the colors, that this is kind of summing up the colors of the collection within one print. So you have the typical kind of Goya lilacs and the greens, but then also the pinks, and then together with something a little bit more deep, like the browns and the navy blues. I think the designer's role in the society now is definitely, it has changed, and I believe that we all have to think differently in the way we put clothes into the world. And this is a nice challenge for me, at least, because I think there are so many possibilities, and I don't feel I have to compromise on anything when I do my collections. We have quite strict goals for each year on how we can be changing the collections and how we can make all the fabrics that we do in, I think it's 2025, we have to have the full collection with responsible fabrics. And I think it's important for every designer to set themselves some goals and how we can make this a more responsible way of putting clothes out in the world. I think one of my biggest failures was actually to listen too much to other people, but maybe more from outside of the company. Like, I have some experiences where I was really influenced by this, we used to work with this amazing agency in France, in Paris, that we were so happy to be there, like with other really amazing brands, and they started like really commenting on how the collections were and giving me advice on how I should kind of develop our print stories, and I did that, and it felt really uncomfortable, but I did it, and we had the worst selling ever, I think. So it just taught me that you have to close the door and listen to what you feel is the right thing for your design. And I think every brand can really fail doing this, like to follow too much what is going on outside. For me, it's really about staying super true to what you believe in yourself.